Senator McCain, all morning we've been showing some of the pork through tax extenders that was put into this bill last night. Please explain to Americans, and let's put the list up again. You've got almost $200 million in this bill for tax breaks for Puerto Rican and Virgin Island rum producers, $128 million for people who make auto racing tracks, wool research, kids' wooden arrows, $6 million. Here we have what Warren Buffett's calling our economic Pearl Harbor, and the Senate still can't help themselves. Why did these items have to be in this critical bill?
Well, that's just the way the system is working in Washington, and the reason why it's got to be fixed and it's got to be changed. And no matter what the stakes are, you've got to stop this by starting to veto bills that come across the president's desk. They can't help themselves. It's insanity and it's obscenity because it's a waste of taxpayers' dollars, and it goes on. And until we stop it, until we get, frankly, a president who will say, I'm going to veto these bills, I'm going to make the people famous that put them on there famous. And by the way, Joe, you know that this problem has grown and grown and grown. Last couple of years they've had some restraint, but it will continue to grow. And it's terrible, and it really is corrupting, because
the buck,
the corruption in Washington.
Go ahead. I'm sorry, Senator.
The corruption in Washington is not the lobbyists. It's a system that allows the lobbyists to take advantage of these backroom deals, these pork barrel projects, these outrageous procedures that the Americans don't know about. You got to fix the system. Then the symptoms of it, I think, in a large degree, are taken
care
of.
Senator, it's Mika Brzezinski here in New York, and we'll be watching the debate tonight to see what happens. I want to just ask you one final question, though, about the bill, because I think, given especially what you've been just saying on our broadcast right now, why then didn't you vote against a bill that is corrupting and stand up to pork and all this spending during an economic crisis that some say this puts this country on the brink of economic disaster?
Because of what you just said, Mika, that this bill is putting us on the brink of economic disaster. There were plenty of other bills that I fought against, voted against. Well, the bill to the Medicare prescription drug program, I voted against it because of the fact that it wasn't paid for. We're laying the cost on to future generations of Americans. I've fought against plenty of bills. I am proud of my work suspending my campaign, coming back to Washington, getting the Republicans at the table, which they were not, improving the bill, and I believe it'll pass. Senator Obama phoned it in.
But if we're going to have leadership through a crisis like this, and if we're going to look to you for that leadership, don't we have to stand up to the very things that are bringing Washington and, at this point, Wall Street down?
If you look at the Citizens for a Sound Economy, the National Taxpayers Union, the Citizens Against Government Waste, I have been a hero to them because I have fought continuously against these.